Well, hello, and welcome back to another scary, scary edition of Ghost Stories Told from the South. I am your host, Stephen LaBooth, and I've got some creepy, scary stuff for you today. Sorry, I've been out for a while. Sinuses have really been kicking my booty, and it's been kind of hard to record and breathe because my nose has been stopped up and I've been sounding like Darth Vader or something. So yes, I'm back and I got a little special treat. I'm going to record these two episodes today, load them tonight on the platform, so they'll be out for this week, and Saturday we'll be back on schedule of putting one out every Saturday like I was. I just had to take a little time off and get rid of this stuff, and I had to get some stuff done outside. It's been raining so much down here in Texas this year. This spring we've had a good rain. I mean, we've had a real good wet spring, and I've had to do a lot of yard work. But I'm back, got back into the schedule of things. I'm going to finish up these two stories today, like I said, and post them, so I have two stories. But next week, I'm going to be talking about, like, urban legends and stuff like that. Since it's summertime, and people have a fire at night, you know, not so much during the heat of the summer, but right now, still kind of, it's good bonfire night, but I'm going to do that, so it's a treat. I'm back. Sorry it took me so long, and I'm going to work on getting my YouTube page caught back up, so thank you to everybody. Hope everybody's having a great Memorial Day weekend. All right, let's get on with our stories. What do you say, guys? Just want to say thank you for all the support and the love, guys. My numbers keep growing and growing. I mean, it's not like monster, like gritting, like big-time hits and stuff, but for a little old guy doing this out of his house with nobody funding me, no advertisements or nothing, excuse me, I think I'm doing pretty good. Numbers are doing good. Followers are growing. Let's keep this thing going, guys. What do you say? All right, you know the routine, man. Go get you a nice warm blankie. Go snuggle up by the fire. Get you some nice hot tea, a cocoa, or some coffee. A cold coffee, whatever you like. And get ready for some scares. Alright, our first story, God, is going to be the Haunted Hotel in Eklund, New Mexico. I'm going to turn my light on just a little bit brighter so I can see. In the heart of America's Southwest, where vast landscapes meet the tales of old and where history and folklore intertwine, lies as a relic of times gone by. The Hotel Eklund, nestled within Clayton, New Mexico, has seemingly been an iconic establishment. It holds stories as captivating as they are intriguing. Since the inception in the late 19th century, the Haunted Hotel Eklund, sorry if I'm butchering that name, has witnessed the ebb in the flow of history, from the busting days of the Wild West to the modern era, all the while accumulating a trove of tales that blur the lines between the living and the spiritual. Too many, the Hotel Eklund stands as a beacons of agricultural beauty, a window into the region's rich past. To others, especially those attuned to the whispers of the otherworldly, it is a place where energies from long eras still roam, echoing their stories' hushed tones. Accounts of ghostly apparitions, unexplained sounds, and that a feeling of being watched all the time. They have tantalized both paranormal and regular skeptics alike, luring them into its historic embrace. But what truly lies behind the ornate facade of the Hotel Eklund? It is merely the sum of its tangled bricks, mortar, and time-worn guest logs. Or is it something more, something scary, that lurks within the corridors? As many embark on its journey to uncover the essential of the New Mexico's most haunted landmarks, excuse me, let's take a trip down memory lane. All right, here is the history. The hotel history stands as a symbol of the Old West and survives as a member of the region's vibrant history. Here's a brief overview of its past. Okay, if you tilt your camera just right, you can see the overview. I'm just kidding. That was a dad joke. It's corny and dumb. Okay, the hotel was built in 1892 by Carl W. Eklund, a Swedish immigrant. He constructed the building using bricks made by native clay. Originally, the hotel was a two-story structure with the ground floor housing a bar in the second floor offering accommodations. The boom of the cattle trade. During its early years, the hotel threaded through its proximity to the burgeoning cattle trade. Clayton was a significant cattle shipping center during the late 19th century and the early 20th century. The Hotel Eklund, being one of the primary establishments in the area, became a favorite stopover for cowboys, ranchers, and other travelers. The Prohibition Era. During the Prohibition Era, it's rumored that the hotel's basement was used for bootlegging operations, making it a hot spot for Clydeston effect activities. The renovations and the expansions. Over the years, the hotel underwent several renovations and several renovations and construction of newer stuff. An additional floor was added to the hotel, providing more guest rooms. In the modern day, in more recent times, the hotel has been restored to capture its historical charm. Many of the rooms still hold an antique furnishings and allowing guests to experience a taste of the Old West. All right, here are some of the hauntings. Ghostly apparitions. There have been reports from guests and staff of seeing apparitions, including the figure of a woman in a Victorian attire. Some believe it is to be the spirit of a former guest or possibly someone linked to the hotel's earlier history. Unexplained sounds. Over the years, numerous accounts have surfaced of mysterious sounds, including footsteps in the halls when no one is present. The sound of children laughing, or even the distant murmur of voices from empty rooms. The cold spots. It's not uncommon for visitors to report sudden unexplainable cold spots in certain areas of the hotel. A phenomenon often linked with paranormal activity. Objects moving. Some tales involve objects that appear to move on their own, suggesting some form of poltergeist activity. Feeling of being watched. One more feeling yet frequently reported experience in the sensation of being observed or not being alone. even when there is no one there. Well, that sounds like a cool place to go visit. Y'all should go visit that. The Eklund Hotel in New Mexico. Go check it out. It sounds pretty cool. I love old buildings like that because they have a lot of history, and you know there's going to be something in there that goes bump in the night. All right, ladies and gents, let's get ready for our next story. All right, our next story is the Herzstein Museum. All right, the Herzstein Memorial Museum is housed in a beautiful old building dating back to 1910. It began its life as a Methodist church, but also served as a skating rink, a bowling alley, and a library. The museum gets its name from Albert Herzstein, whose foundation paid for extensive renovations and restoration of the building in 1987. Albert was the son of pioneers. His parents built the first cinema in Clayton, New Mexico, in addition to operating a successful title business. A tile business. To honor the Herzstein family, one whole exhibit in the museum is dedicated to all the interesting treasures and artifacts they collected from the travelers around the world. Other expeditions deal with the Santa Fe Trail, Native Americans, and the Dust Bowl, and other aspects of New Mexico's history. With so many different artifacts, with a building used for as many different purposes, it's difficult to pinpoint exactly who or what is causing the hauntings. However, museum staff feel that the main ghost to call Herzstein's home is a sassy older lady. In 2015, a ghost haunting group claims to have caught the apparition of a woman in white on video. Executive director of the museum, Victoria Baker, has also noted that the sound of disemboweled high-heeled footsteps has been heard in the kitchen area. Paranormal investigators have produced an EVP of the little boy's voice in a back bedroom area. Poltergeist activity and strange noises throughout the museum include a rattling noise on or near the staircase. Quite a few videos exist on YouTube from the various ghost haunting groups sharing the Herzstein's evidence. But you can view the 2015 apparition photo right from the local Chamber of Congress website. Clayton, New Mexico is embracing its haunted history and leaving it up to its reputation as New Mexico's most haunted city. If you're ever in the area, come check it out. It'll be grand. Oh, my Lanta. All right. Let's get ready for our next little story. Reconstructed in 1904. We're talking about the Union County Courthouse. Reconstruction in 1909 after a tornado tore through the original courthouse. The Union City Courthouse today is said to be a hot spot for many cold spots. Lingering spirits. Before the new courthouse was built, Black Jack Ketchum's hanging was right in front of the original courthouse. Today, legend has it that Black Jack Ketchum haunts the halls, headless or not. The jailhouse where he was kept until he met his fate and is said to be his ice cold, even to this day. Other reported sightings have spooked those who still work in the 1909 courthouse. Someday they said they have even seen full apparitions. Others only have been able to capture orbs or surrounding them constantly. All right. And I'm sorry, but that was a really short one, guys. I'm so sorry about that. You know, this one just might be... Well, this one's pretty long. All right, let's get on with the next one. I hope you all enjoyed that one. I couldn't dig up a whole lot about that courthouse, but that's crazy. Half of it got hit by a tornado and had to be rebuilt and all that in 1909. And just think about it. Back then, when bad weather came, they had no warnings or nothing. When it hit, it hit. So poor people probably didn't know what was coming. But anyways, let's get on with our next and probably last story of this. Sorry, it's just shorty. All right. Our next story is the Philmount Scout Ranch. The area around Clayton has seen its fair share of bloodshed and horror. It's no surprise that it makes it on its list of haunted places in New Mexico. If you want to cut them sandwiches, you can.
Oh, they're ready?
Yeah. Thomas Blackjack Ketchum was the only person ever hanged in Clayton. New Mexico was Thomas Blackjack Ketchum was the only person ever hanged in Clayton, New Mexico. He was executed for the crime of a train robbery. One thing that makes Blackjack Ketchum really unlikely is that he was also the only person ever hanged in the state of New Mexico for train robbery. The law was found to be unconstitutional shortly after his hanging. Encounters with the ghost. One camper recounts his experience of running into the ghost of Thomas Blackjack Ketchum. He had a run-in with the legendary train robber while camping. It was near the Philmount Scout Ranch in the nearby mountains with other Boy Scouts. One area they decided to camp near was an abandoned gold mine that served as Ketchum's hideout. The hideout was a large rock hangover. The scouts thought it would be fun to camp there for the night. However, the leader insisted that they stay at a nearby designed site. Disappointed, several of the scouts set their tents up several hundred feet away from the leader's tent. Suddenly, one of the raucous campers was awakened by a noise in the bushes. He said that he felt paralyzed, unable to move, and tried to call out for others. Then he saw a cowboy dressed up all in black come running out of the bushes towards the hideout. He said that the man was mostly solid, but some parts of him appeared translucent. I'm sorry. Describing the man as filthy dirty, with a tattered hat, clothes from the 1800s, and terrible yellow teeth. His face was very red, glistening with sweat, with lots of facial hair in the apparition held of a revolver. The cowboy was apparently unaware of the soul, but the boy was very scared. The strange fog embedded from the tree line across from a small stream, and he could hear men yelling and then muffled gunfire. The cowboy turned around and fired the bazooka. No, I'm just kidding. Fired the revolver 6 times into the trees and then ran and stood right over the scout. The cowboy was wounded in the shoulder and discharged 6 bullets from his revolver right on top of him. As he watched, the bullets disappeared as they fell into the sleeping bag. The cowboy then reloaded his revolver, fired additional shots into the trees, and suddenly the cowboy saw the scout. The expression on the cowboy's faces indicated that the scout had just suddenly appeared before his eyes. He seemed to be confused and confronted, while the scout was terrified. Then the cowboy uncocked his pistol, looking at the scout very closely, and said, "You're not supposed to be here." And then he just disappeared in the air. Seems like after death, they still like to haunt their place. Come on. All right, guys. I think that is it. You know, I thought I had 2 stories. Anyways, the announcement I made at first. This is the last of this kind of series of stories talking about places. Now my next story's coming out will be on like campfire stories and urban legends and stuff like that. So don't forget now, I'm going to download this one. And then right after I download this one, I'm going to have one more I'm going to do for you guys. And then next Saturday, we'll be back on track. So don't forget, I got one more coming after this one. So you get a 2 for today. 2 for today. But all right, guys, we will see you later. Have a great one. Have a good one. I'm glad you stopped by. Sorry this one was so short. And sorry that I haven't been doing these. But I'm back on track now. Everything's fine, like a bottle of wine, baby. So you guys be spooky, be scary, and we will holler at you later. And don't be scared now, you hear? And remember, this is Ghost Stories Told from the South. You can catch its podcast on any platform, and go check out the YouTube channel Ghost Stories Told from the South too, guys. But until next time, we'll see you later. Have a great one. Have a good one. And if I don't see you before it rains, have a good one. Anyways, be scary, guys. We'll see you on the next episode. Bye.